started off in a record pace against Southern Mississippi, booting four field goals and leading Georgia to a 26-19 victory. Clemson sports one of the best kicking tandems in the country. Ranked ninth nationally coming into the game is punter Dale Hatcher. In 11 punts this year, only one has been returned. This is it, and that's only for 2 yards. Dale Hatcher, and handling the place-kicking shorts for the Tigers, is Donald Igwe-Bleke. So far this season, he is perfect on point afters and field goals, and has 7 of 12 non-returnable kickoffs. Today, it's the Clemson Tigers versus the Georgia Bulldogs. Raycom Sports presents Clemson Tiger Football. Today, from Sanford Stadium, it's the Clemson Tigers versus the Georgia Bulldogs. Today's game is brought to you by Trans South. We are proud to lend to you. And Budweiser, the king of beers. Reach for that distinctively clean, crisp taste that says Budweiser. For all you do, this Bud's for you. And Mazda, and the full line of sophisticated Mazda products. And by Zenith Data Systems. Quality goes in before the name goes on. Some travel arrangements made through Eastern, the airline with more flights to more of Florida. This year, come fly away to a magic kingdom with Eastern, the official airline of Walt Disney World. A sun-baked crowd at Sanford Stadium in Athens, Georgia, awaiting the Clemson Tigers versus the Georgia Bulldogs. Hello, everybody. I'm Art Ekman, and working with me is Kim McQuilkin. And, Kim, there's no better example in the United States, I don't think, as teams using home field advantage than the Bulldogs and the Tigers in this series.
Well, that's exactly right. Both teams have been tough at home through this series. Clemson's only ever won one game here in Sanford Stadium, and even though they're the favorites, they're going to be hard-pressed for a victory here today.
I bet Vince Dooley's a little happy he might have a home field advantage because he says this is the most inexperienced team he's had in the previous 21 seasons he's been at Georgia.
Well, he does feel he needs that home field advantage this year. He's only had one starter returning on offense, and I think this game's going to get down to the kicking game, Art. It's been a hard fought series, a low-scoring series, and I think the kicking game's going to be a big factor this afternoon.
Both teams on the field. When we come back, we'll have the opening kickoff of today's game.
Time. It takes time to create quality. The quality taste of Budweiser. Time to select the choicest ingredients. For exclusive Beechwood aging, to brew the distinctively clean, crisp taste of Budweiser. Quality taste. That's what people want in a cold glass of beer. And this is the one they want. Somebody still cares about quality.
The Georgia Bulldogs and Coach Vince Dooley. He is a graduate of the University of Auburn. But while here at Georgia, he has won 162 games to become the ninth winningest active coach in major college football. On the other side of the field, Danny Ford, a graduate of Alabama. 47 wins, 11 losses, 2 ties. He's the fourth winningest active coach in the NC2A, but he's never won a game here at Sanford Stadium, Tim McQuilkin.
Well, that's exactly right. He's favored here this afternoon, Art, but as we mentioned at the top of the show, Clemson has only won one game here in its last 16 tries, so they've got their hands full.
Clemson won the opening toss. They declined the decision for the first half. Georgia has elected to receive. So Donald Igwe-Bleke will be kicking off with the wind at his back. It's true that the series is 34 wins for Georgia, 13 wins for Clemson, and 4 ties. But from 1915 through 1973, Georgia had a 21-1-2 advantage. But since then, things have certainly tightened up. Donald Igwe-Bleke with Fred Lane and Andre Smith back to receive. Igwe-Bleke doing a great job in kickoff once again this year. It's Freddie Lane to the near side, and Andre Smith to the far side. Igwe Wike puts the toe to it. Andre Smith going back into the end zone, too deep to run out. They'll take over at the 20-yard line. First and 10, Georgia, at their own 20. The Georgia offense, as Kim told us in the opening, very, very inexperienced. Todd Williams is one of the few with some game experience as he comes in at quarterback. An inexperienced line anchored by the sometime starter in 1983, Peter Anderson at center. You see him there. Williams at quarterback. Inexperienced running backs, Lane and Archie, experienced receivers, however. That's Lane in motion. And the pitch back goes to Mangrum. Mangrum stacks up short of the 20-yard line. Steve Berlin getting off the pack. 15 tackles this year, three of them for loss, and one sack on the season, the 6'5 junior from Bethel Park, Pennsylvania. The defensive lineups now for the Clemson team. Outland Trophy candidate William Perry, flanked by Berlin and brother Michael. Wells at left end. The bandit is Terrence Mack, and the linebackers Walden, Milton, Davis, Watson, Danforth, and Pleasant. The defensive secondary. Mangrum on the carry. Penalty flagged out as he tries to get back to the line of scrimmage. So far, the Clemson line has bottled things up, Jim.
Well, that's exactly right. Danny Ford, at the beginning of this season, was concerned about his defensive line. Very early in the season, they have dominated play. Here we see William Perry fighting off the block of the center. Great pursuit by this Clemson defense. Nowhere to go outside. Ball carrier's got to turn it up. Look at all those white jerseys there, Art.
So it'll be a second down and 20 yards for the Georgia Bulldogs. Peter Anderson over the ball at center. That's Andre Smith. Andre Smith can't hit the hole quick enough. As Jeff Wells, who gets his 12th tackle of the year, secures it for the Clemson Tigers. He's a three-year veteran, this Jeff Wells.
We mentioned that we felt the kicking game would be a big factor in this ball game. Along with that, Art, is field position. Vince Dooley's got an inexperienced quarterback in there, second and 20, didn't want to try anything fancy. Now he's got a third and 18, and I'm sure he's going to be very careful as to his play selection early in this game.
Archie split to the far side, and Osborne is in the slot. He's the man in motion right now. Third and long yardage, penalty flag in the air. Looks like it might be a delay of game. So the Bulldogs backing themselves in the corner.
And this is a call you see quite a bit when one team is on the far end of the field. The plays have to be sent in from the sideline. Sometimes it takes a while to get in there. They're going to be backed up to their 6-yard line now.
15 yards in penalties marched off against Georgia here in the opening series of plays.
I would be very surprised to see anything but a very conservative call here.
Lane and Archie to the near side for the Georgia Bulldogs. Mangrum. He's stopped by Jeff Wells.
And all Vince Dooley was trying to do here was get some room for his punter to come in.
Dooley's punter is Chip Andrews. He had three punts in the opening game of the year, averaging 47.3.
He and Hatcher, the punter for Clemson, who's ranked
ninth in
the country,
the senior from Pinewood, South Carolina, is back on the 48-yard line. Andrews out of his end zone. Well, beautiful hang time on this one. Pleasant goes back. He'll have time to catch it at the 35. Does the next best thing, just go straight up the field. And the Clemson Tigers take over with good field position after a tackle by David McCluskey.
What a great punt by Andrews back in his own end zone. He really came through.
Clemson offense. As you see Mike Epley going into the huddle. Engel, Reese, Wayne, Cheatham, Ellis, K.D. Dunn, the fine tight end. Epley at quarterback, Flowers at fullback, Stacy Driver starting as he comes back to his home state of Georgia. Rulak and Butler are the wideouts. Epley goes to the air on the first play, but his receiver fell down. Epley, the great athlete he is, now taking time. Intended for Williams, and it was batted out of bounds by Kevin Harris. Harris, a player that came over from the offensive side of things because of weakness in depth in the cornerback spot, Jim.
Well, that's right, and here you see Epley letting the ball go a little late. He wanted to go to his right originally. All the receivers were covered, trying to make something happen. He came back to his left, and a good job by the Georgia defense that time.
Epley, as you see there, number one of the nation in pass efficiency. Boyer and Williams are the wideout. Stacy Driver gets the call, and he breaks off the pass. First down and more. Out of bounds at the 44. Tony Flack forces him out there. The Georgia defensive line is anchored by Kenny Sims from Greenville, South Carolina. 13 tackles last year in one game against Auburn. Lloyd Chumley, Harris, compliment. Behind the cornerback, they have walk-ons for experience. First set from the 40. Epley to Stacy Driver. First down, and more as he goes down about the 29. Andy Loy from the left end spot making his fifth tackle of the year. Loy's from Knoxville, Tennessee, a 6'1", 214 junior.
And on the last two plays, Art, Clemson has been exploiting the short side of the football field. This time, Epley on the option, looking right at that defensive end, lets it go, and Driver's got the outside. Look at him go down the sideline.
Stacy Driver, second carry, 29 yards on his first series of plays. Boyer is to the far side, and Rulak comes to the near side. First and 10. Stacy Driver in motion, right up the middle. And getting to the 25-yard line, a gain of about 4.5 yards, is Kenny Flowers. Flowers comes into this game with 21 carries for a total of 87 yards. That's a 4.1 average.
Clemson using a wing formation. They're actually putting the wingman in motion, which turns it into a one-back offense, similar to what we see quite a bit in the NFL. There's that wingback now lined up right.
Second and 6 now for the Tigers. Epley looks back over the middle to Williams. Williams is piled out at the 17-yard line. It should be good enough for the first down. It is. It's Butler, the receiver on the play, and he's met by Bill Mitchell, number 56.
Now, this is the same play they tried the first play of the game. Epley's going to sprint left. He wants to throw the throwback back to his right. This time, he's got his man wide open underneath the coverage, and it's good enough for a first down.
Clemson with a diversified, very versatile offense, showing it in this first drive. Boyer and Williams, the wideout. Williams is to the far side. First and 10 from the 17-yard line. Epley on the option, back to Driver. Oh, as he hits solidly that time at the 15-yard line by Tony Flack. Flack from Greensboro, North Carolina. He's a junior, but with 2 years of varsity experience.
Flack that time was a support man, and he was up there to make the tackle early.
Culpepper calling the defensive signals there in the huddle for the Georgia Bulldogs out of Lovett High School in Atlanta. The big rap on him was he wouldn't have enough speed to be a collegiate linebacker, but don't tell Georgia fans that. He's all SEC. Second and 8, in the open, done. Touchdown! What a beautiful play call, Kim McClurkin.
What a great individual effort by KD Dunn to get into the end zone. Epley just took 3 steps and hit Dunn over the middle, and he dragged the rover, Little, right into the end zone with him.
Check out the action now. As Little tries all he can do at 6'2", 194 pounds, he's only a sophomore, to haul the big guy down.
As we saw, Epley didn't even get set. He just let that ball go. And done with a fine individual effort.
Big boy Bouygues now, trying to keep that perfect record intact. He's 12 out of 12 and make it 13 out of 13. With 10 minutes and 33 seconds to be played here in the first quarter. Clemson, on their first possession, scores and leads this ball game 7-0. We'll be back with more action right after this. Another look at the touchdown play, the pass, Epley to KD Dunn. 31, our correction is Sanchez. Sanchez, out all last year with an injury, cannot handle the tight end one-on-one.
Not when you've got a tight end that big and that close to the end zone. That's a tough play for the safety. What Georgia did not do in that play, Art, is hold up Dunn at the line of scrimmage.
Andre Smith and Fred Lane deep to receive the kickoff from Amboise Wike. The drive going 58 yards in eight plays. 1 minute, 56 seconds there. You see time of possession. Epley to Dunn for the 16-yard scoring pass. 7-0 Clemson. Amboise Wike, his second try at a non-returnable. Freddie Lane says, no, I'm not going to run it out. Wisely so. First and 10, Georgia, in their second possession here in the first quarter from their own 20-yard line. So Donald Igwe Buike right now, as we see him on the sideline, receiving congratulations, has 9 unreturnable kickoffs in 14 tries. Last season's total offensive figures, as Todd Williams brings him to the line of scrimmage, first and 10. Williams looking for Archie, locks the ball, intercepted by Watson. Ronald Watson. Penalty flag goes down. Watson playing that perfectly. That's his first interception of the year. The young man from Jefferson, Georgia.
Well, Todd Williams, the Georgia quarterback, tried to roll to the short side of the field and throw a go pattern down the sideline. But when you're going into that short side of the field, you cannot hang the ball.
Todd Williams.
We'll see Todd. He puts a lot of air under the ball, and that allows Ronald Watson to come over and make the play. The penalty is going to go against Clemson, Art.
That's right. They won't take over the football at that point where Watson returned the interception, because the clipping call goes back to the 46-yard line. Well, one very irate customer on the Clemson team as he left the field was William Perry. But we don't have official confirmation as to who the clip was on. But Clemson with better field possession than they started the last time. From the 46-yard line, Williams goes into the slot, the handoff. And it's Flagler. Flagler, a gain of a couple of yards. Terrence Flagler has not lost a yard this year. He's done a terrific job in 16 carries for 126 yards coming into this game. That's a 7.9 average. Linebackers Mitchell and Culpepper in to make the stop for Georgia after a gain of make it 3 yards, 2nd and 7. Epley continuing his great pass efficiency in the first drive, hit 2 for 3. Now he sends Charleston to the far side and Ray Williams to the near side. Epley to the air. That's an eligible receiver. As Carlisle Hewitt was looking for his fourth tackle and first sack of the season, but couldn't get it.
Well, the fans don't like it. They're looking for the intentional grounding call. Here we see the play action pass to Flagler. Epley keeps the ball and continues to roll out, but Georgia's doing a good job deep in the secondary.
Not only that, Kim, but Flagler could not get through the blockers in time to get into the batter.
Well, we've got a big play here, 3rd and 7, Art.
3rd down 7. Butler, far to the right side, and Williams to the near side. Epley against the four-man rush. Going long to Williams. Intercepted by Sanchez. Sanchez, 2 years ago, was second in the nation in interceptions, only behind teammate Terry Hogue.
Well, that's exactly right. Last year, Sanchez was out all year with a broken arm. Epley's got time. He lets it go, but he throws it into the coverage. Sanchez has time to come over.
That's the first interception in something like 35 straight passes for Epley.
Well, we talked about field position. So far, it's been all Clemson.
Up the middle, no room at all. 7-0 Clemson, 9:22 remaining first quarter.
You know, that time, Art, I think Todd Williams fumbled the snap from center. Georgia's lucky they didn't turn the ball over on that play.
Osborne comes into the lineup.
Now, Art, this is a real tough situation for an inexperienced quarterback playing against one of the top teams in the country, deep in his own territory. You know the butterflies have to be going just a little bit.
Second down and 10. Williams. Low throw to Archie. Archie was in the open. It looked like he just held onto the football too long on the delivery.
Well, he's rolling to his left. He needs to get those shoulders square to the line of scrimmage before he lets the ball go. I think he's probably a little tight. Archie was open on a curl pattern, and he was coming back to the ball, which is what you want the receiver to do. But Todd let it go just a bit too early, pulled the string on it. They've got a third and 10.
Williams 0 for 2 in the passing department. Don't forget, though, he engineered those two drives last year in the fourth quarter to tie the game at 16-16. Look out! There it's Mack back at the 4-yard line. Mack with 12 tackles, 2 interceptions. He had a great year last year with 39 tackles as a freshman. Watch him blast through.
Well, Clemson does something here they normally won't do early in the game. They gambled. They sent Terrence Mack. They came up, played a tight man-to-man defense, a pressing defense, and they were relying on the pass rush. That time, Terrence Mack, the bandit, got in and got the sack. A big sack for Clemson.
Reggie Pleasant is deep. He's run back 8 punts for 64 yards. 17 yards is longest. And look at Andrews with his back foot on the back line. Only one man really penetrating, and a nice hanging high punt. Fair catch called for, but they wouldn't give him room to catch it. And the penalty flag will go down. You got to give him room. Wave for the fair catch, and Kenny Driscoll wouldn't let him have it, a junior from Macon, Georgia.
Well, Clemson really wanted this return, too, even though Andrews is in the back of the end zone. Clemson elected not to rush the punter. They peeled everybody back. They had the return on, but didn't even get a chance to catch the ball.
Well, that'll get them some good yardage, though, with the mistake on the penalty.
Look at the field position Clemson is going to take over with.
So Georgia, who has fallen victim to the penalty department here in the first quarter, will have to defend from the 27. Richard Butler in at split end. Ray Williams, your flanker. Steve Griffin is the tailback, moving back into the eye as Dunn shifts to the right side of the line. Epley hands to Griffin. Griffin tries to knife through. Yellow flag down at the 25. Donald Tremblay made the tackle. He had a fine first game against Southern Mississippi with 8 tackles, a sack, also deflecting a pass.
And whenever you see that flag in the middle of the line of scrimmage, you've got to think holding. That's what it's going to be. We've got a holding call against Clemson. Danny Ford doesn't like it.
Griffin goes back to the tailback spot. Takes the Flowers. K.D. Dunn. Booms his way past Black, but he was down after the fumble. Inside the 10-yard line, Jeff Sanchez making the tackle. Epley got hit hard, there's no question about that, with the rush.
Well, Epley's going to fake the dive. The Flowers, he pulls up right away. The looky pass, and there you see him getting hit. But what Georgia's not doing, Art, is they are not holding up KD Dunn at the line of scrimmage. They've got to put a linebacker in his face and not let him get off the ball because he's no match for those safeties downfield.
Epley, 3 for 6 for 49 yards. Henry Harris was the young man from the left guard position that came through to really put the snap on the quarterback. First and goal. 9 yards to go. Good tackle at the line of scrimmage on Kenny Flowers. Once again, it was Henry Harris. He got help from Max Culpepper. Henry Harris is an interesting story. Went to his high school coach, Columbia High School in Atlanta, Georgia, said, "Coach, I don't know how to read, and I want to go to college." And he saw a lot of other gentlemen around them getting college scholarships from that school. And Ray Bonner, the coach there, and the principal, got him in a special academic program, and he even came to Georgia a semester early. He graduated early from high school. Griffin on the carry, very little running room as he tries to inch his way to the 5-yard line on the second and goal. Andy Loy making the tackle, and Jeff Sanchez helping out.
This is, of course, where the yardage gets tough inside that 10-yard line. He's got a third and six now from the six.
Butler brings the play into the huddle.
The great thing about having Epley in there at quarterback guard is you can roll out, you can run the option, you can run the pass. He can do it all.
The Bulldogs back in now with 6:03 remaining first quarter. Epley going to the air to the lob. Williams can't get to it. He hit the corner of the end zone, but Williams just couldn't get to it. Tony Flack on the coverage.
Well, when you have man-to-man coverage, a good call sometimes is what we call a step and go in the pros. The receiver just takes one step at that defender, then out to his outside. Epley, it's a timing pass, wants to try to put it over his outside shoulder. That time Mike just lost the ball a bit too much. And Clemson's going to have to settle for a field goal.
It was week 3 for 3 in the field goal department, as long as 49, but this one will have a ball placement at the 12. It's up and powers it out of the stadium. Igwe Buike puts 3 more on the board, and Clemson, with 5:53 remaining in the first quarter, leads the University of Georgia by the score of 10-0. We'll pause now for a word from your local station. This is the Raycom Sports Network. 2,122 here at Sanford Stadium in Athens, Georgia. First and 10 from the 10. Andre Smith, Jerry Cleveland. Cleveland! Outside the 25 to the 26. Chucky Richardson, the tackle. Cleveland just coming into the ball game. Is not even on the 2-deep.
Over right guard. Good blocking by that right side of Georgia. Straight up the middle.
Cleveland, only a freshman from Indiantown, Florida. It's the first offensive opening, really, for the Georgia Bulldogs.
Look at the move there by the freshman.
First and 10 from their own 27-yard line. Fred Lane in motion. Archie cutting across the field. They slip it off to Lane, and Lane is out of bounds at the 32-yard line. Richard Donaldson, strong safety, a senior, 5'10", two-year letterman from Fayetteville, North Carolina, makes the defensive stop.
And whether you have experience or you're inexperienced, that first completion always makes you feel a little better. I'm sure that just hitting that first quick out there is going to make Todd Williams settle down a bit.
Second down and 5 for the Bulldogs. Lane and Hockaday, the wideout. Cleveland, the carry. Moves over the 35, short of the first down by a couple of yards. Dwayne Meadows and William Perry making the stop. Perry coming off that great ball game where he was named ACC Player of the Week against the University of Virginia. Career high of 11 tackles, 4 for losses against the Cavaliers.
Well, not only is Perry big, Art, but he's so quick. He really plays from sideline to sideline.
Important. Third down. Penalty flag goes in the air. He would make a first down, but let's check the yellow hanky. Ronald Watson, known as the hitter, comes up to make his 7th tackle of the year. Richard Donaldson also making a stop, and the penalty will be against Clemson. Offside, Clemson declined. First down, Georgia Bulldogs at the 40-yard line.
Well, there you see a good block on Terry by the center. They're outside, though, off the right tackle. Just a good job by that right side of Georgia's.
That crowd of 82,122, incidentally, is the same exact crowd total back in 1982 in Athens here. The largest crowd ever to see Clemson football in a stadium. Once again, they go to the tailback. Oh, what a hit! Fumble. And evidently he was down. Tyrone Davis that time coming up to make a beautiful hit.
You're going to see the right side of the Georgia line doing another good job. That's Jimmy Holton and Mike Weaver, the right tackle, sealing off the Clemson defense. And that's good yardage on first down. Georgia's got a second and four now. That's exactly the kind of yardage you need to keep moving those chains.
Lane is in the slot with Archie to the near side on a second and four at the 46-yard line. On the option, they both went for the quarterback, and Cleveland is corralled before he can get a first down. Donaldson once again making the stop.
That last hit by Tyrone Davis kind of reminds you of the kind of hits Ronald Watson's been making the last 2 years.
Tommy Harper, the defensive coordinator now, has already given his defense the side. William Perry at that middle spot, flanked by Berlin and Michael Perry. Third and one at the 49. Perry, does he make it? I don't think he made it. He has to get over the 50 to the 49. Steve Berlin in to make the crucial tackle with help from Walls, I believe. No, Chucky Richardson, the linebacker. So Cleveland Gary does not make the first down, I believe. Let's check it. No, it is the first down, now they say. He did get over the 50 far enough.
Well, it was close. Georgia in a short yardage offense tried the old student body right. They had everybody out in front. Tyrone Davis for Clemson did a good job of turning it in, but they got just enough for the first down.
Lars Tate at tailback. And the first and 10 from the 49. Williams. Flip. Pushed out of bounds. Andre Smith, the fullback, by Keith Williams.
Well, this is a great call by Georgia. Coming back on first down, there you see the misdirection play fake. And this kind of pass where Williams just jumps it off as quick as possible to the fullback out in the flat, that's a big confidence builder. You don't need a lot of pass protection. It keeps the momentum going. I think a good call by Georgia on first down.
Lars Tate, a promising prospect for the Georgia Bulldogs. Came into the game with 31 yards rushing, an 11-yard touchdown run. He's a high school All-American. So from the 39-yard line, watching the ball. Once again to the single back, and with very little running room is Tate. Throwing off to the left side, gets back to the line of scrimmage before Reggie Pleasant makes a nice adjustment from the defensive secondary.
Well, I think that...
Penalty flag down, Jim.
Yeah, I think Steve Berlin's gonna be offside for Clemson. Just hopping over the line of scrimmage before the snap. Georgia no doubt will take this penalty. They'll be looking at first and five.
Maybe we can see who jumped.
There's Berlin's hand right there.
You're right. 45 yards in penalties with 17 seconds left in the first quarter against Clemson. So 40 yards marched off earlier against Georgia. Hurt the Bulldogs. We'll see if the Bulldogs can capitalize now against the Tigers. First and five. Tate, big hole. Tate to the 26-yard line. Victor Perry with a great block. And Henry Walls made the tackle.
And you're going to see the right side of the Georgia line. Triple team William Perry. He's got two men on him there. Here comes the third guy in, cleaning him up. Look at the hole that's created on that right side. Steve Berlin's there too late. And that's going to be a big first down for Georgia.
Mack Burrows, number 69, and number 77, Victor Perry, both pulling to the outside so that they could shift gears and cut up the middle. That's the end of the first quarter now. With the score, you see it. Clemson Tigers 10, the Georgia Bulldogs nothing.
For your nearest dealer of Zenith quality for the smart set of the Z100 desktop computer, call 1-800-334-0087.
As we start the second quarter, they'll start it on the 25-yard line of the Clemson Tigers for the first down. Archie to the far side and Fred Lane to the near side. Tate is the tailback. Andre Smith, the up man in that I formation. Andre Smith, the carrier. Sliding off that middle guard spot, the nose guard, William Perry.
Georgia penetrated down inside. There we see the score 10-0. Of course, Clemson ahead, but they're down inside the 25-yard line now in a game that could have been a blowout earlier in the first quarter. They need to get out of here with some short of the score. Even a field goal right now would turn the momentum around entirely.
Berlin, Perry, and Perry. The men in the trenches defensively on a 2nd and 7. Penalty flag goes in the air as the tight end, Scott Williams, might have prompted that barrage by the Tigers coming over the line of scrimmage, mainly Craig Crawford, number 49.
And the kind of mistake you cannot afford down here. Looking at a 2nd and 7, now they're 2nd and 12. Going to change the play call.
Well, you wonder who's going to have the last penalty. Yeah. That might mean who wins the game. Both teams have been penalized 45 yards in the early going. This is the 11th play of this drive for Georgia. 2nd down and 12. Williams gets around Perry. Collapsed upon by Craig Crawford. Good quick adjustment by Crawford that time, Tim.
Well, it was, but William Perry just comes clean. We're going to see it here in the replay. Right guard Jimmy Holt blocking on William Perry, and he loses it. Look at Perry in there, 330 pounds. But Todd Williams showing great escapability. At least gets back to the line of scrimmage, maybe even picked up a yard. Steve Berlin, Craig Crawford, both in there on the tackle.
Here's another look at it as Williams goes back, and you can see now that big Perry coming in there.
He's using Williams. His strength that time, Art, right through two men.
Said he hoped his quickness would get out of the way of the big guy. 3rd and 12. They dump it off to Tate. Tate tries to sneak through and wiggles down to the 19. They might place it at the 18-yard line. Terrence Mack close to the play defensively.
Georgia tries a rollout to their left. This is their version of the throwback. Williams is going to set up and look right. There's Lars Tate. Got the ball in good shape. He's got some running room, just short of the first down.
Jimmy Harrell will hold for Kevin Butler. Butler's ball placement at the 25, just short of the 25. Plenty of leg. It looks good. It is good. University of Georgia hits the scoreboard with a field goal from Kevin Butler. With 12 minutes, 44 seconds remaining before halftime, Clemson 10, Georgia 3. We'll pause now for a word from your local station. This is the Raycom Sports Network. Art Ekman and Jim McQuilkin bringing you this very fine rivalry between Clemson and Georgia. Clemson with the best record in the nation in the last 3 years, 31-2-2. Georgia, if you count 4 years, has the best mark in the nation, 44-4-1. Epley goes to the air, or tries. Looks for Williams. Threw it as close to the sideline as possible, knowing that it could easily be picked off. It was intended for Ray Williams. Jeff Sanchez in the area.
And this is a smart play by an experienced quarterback. The roll to his left. He's buying time. What he decides to do here is he's going to put it at a place where if only his man can get it or no one else can get it, and that's exactly what he does. On the sidelines, out of bounds. Rather than force it in there, it's a good play by Epley.
3 for 9 through the air with 1 interception, a total of 49 yards for Mike Epley at quarterback, and a 2nd and 10 still from the 20. The up man in the I formation, Kenny Flowers, number 48. Kenny Sims, who had an outstanding game against Southern Mississippi with 8 tackles, gets one in this ball game. Henry Harris also helping out.
So far in this ball game, while Georgia's given up a couple of key passes to the tight end Dunn, they've done an excellent job of covering Clemson's wide receivers.
3rd and 7. Rulak and Williams are the wide receivers. And Epley, looking for Williams, dumps it off to his back, and he drops the ball. Terrence Flagler. So the sophomore can't hold on to it, but the Georgia defense holds on.
Well, here's Epley back in the pocket. He wanted Ray Williams, but Georgia had Williams covered. He goes to his secondary receiver, Flagler, and Flagler can't hang on to the ball. Good protection that time by the Clemson offensive line.
Hatcher back at his 10-yard line. It's a beautiful booming kick away as Harold waits at the 30. hit at the 35. And doesn't get over there. So Hatcher with great tank time. Georgia, though, takes over just shy of their own 35-yard line. Cleveland Gary, the tailback. Andre Smith, the fullback, on a first and 15. Williams to Gary. Gary gets back to the original line of scrimmage at about the 34-yard line when he's met by Keith Williams. Steve Berlin helping out with an assist.
Pretty good line surge that time by the Georgia offensive line. Defensively, Clemson has been moving William Perry around. He's played both tackle spots so far and seems to be moving almost alternating every other play. That way, the Georgia offensive line cannot get their double teams on him every time.
Second down, 11 for the Bulldogs. Bandit almost got the quarterback, and he released it a little early. Ken Brown coming in for Terrence Mack at that Bandit spot, comes crashing through, and Williams just didn't have sufficient time.
Well, Todd Williams pays the price here. A rollout to his right, no one blocking Kenny Brown, the Bandit, and you're going to see him have a clean shot at Williams. Todd really lucky to get the ball off and lucky to bounce back up.
Williams, 3 for 7 with 2 interceptions, 24 yards through the air. Williams wants a timeout. So over 10 minutes and 33 seconds to be played here in the second quarter. Timeout is called by the Bulldogs. Clemson leading Georgia by the score of 10-3. We'll be back to Athens, Georgia with more football action after this. 9 minutes, 49 seconds remaining here in the second quarter. Clemson 10, Georgia 3. Second and 12 from the 14-yard line. Ron Jackson in a tailback. Fans are on their feet as far as the Bulldog fans are concerned as Williams decides he's going to tuck it under. Nice adjustment. Fighting off the block was Jeff Wells, number 88. That interior line is Mike Weaver, 63, Holton, 66, and Anderson, 64.
Todd Williams is going to roll to his right. He wants to pass. There's double coverage out there on the wide receiver. He tucks it underneath and just cuts it upfield and gets what he can. Not a bad play. They've got a 3rd and 6 now, 3rd and 7.
So the Bulldogs trying to capitalize on a great break, recovering a fumble deep in Clemson territory, now with a 3rd and 8 at the 10-yard line. Williams on the lob, broken up on the play. Tyrone Davis, broken, and it was intended for Herman Archie.
Well, you're going to see a safety blitz here by Kenny Danforth, number 32, to the left of your screen. We just missed it, but he came in and hit Williams just as he was letting go of the ball. The ball's underthrown, that step-and-go pattern that we talked about earlier. Tyrone Davis on the coverage of Herman Archie.
Looked like Tyrone might have gotten his second interception of the year if he'd have turned around when the ball was in flight. Butler now preparing for his second field goal try from the 16-yard line. Kevin Butler with 4 field goals against Southern Mississippi in the Bulldogs' first game of the year. It is no good.
Hard to believe.
So the young man who holds the SEC record for the most field goals and, of course, the University of Georgia record cannot connect.
Well, Reggie Pleasant on the previous field goal almost blocked the field goal. This attempt, he was in there again, and that may have bothered Butler.
Butler's got tremendous concentration.
Let's look at 29 coming from the left side of the screen here, Reggie Pleasant. He's going to lay out.
And he
really wasn't, close that time, but Butler may have been thinking about him after that last kick.
Jim Riggs, the tight end. Sheldon Boyer and Rulak, the wide receiver. Definitely, though, goes to the tailback. Tailback doesn't have much running room as he gets up to about the 8-yard line. Driver is met by Henry Harris. Henry Harris, a linebacker in high school, is up front of the trenches here in college.
Well, it's still 2nd and 22. You don't want to get too fancy down in here, but yet you don't want to turn the ball over in good field position. Sometimes a good call down here is a straight go pattern.
Culpepper, Mitchell, and Lloyd playing the role of linebackers. No running room. anticipating exactly what happened. The Bulldog defense, Kenny Flowers, had no place to go. Chumley has played an excellent defensive game here in the first half. He came in to make the stop, the 6'4 senior from Savannah. So, third and 17 from the 13. The safety driver, too much time though, I believe.
Just a lay of game again.
And we've got more yardage to be stepped off against the Tigers.
Well, you can bet both coaches at halftime are going to be talking to their players about poise, because the team that comes out in the second half and shows the most poise is going to win this game.
So the delay of game puts the ball way back. Make it third and 22 from the 8. So with Hatcher getting ready, Rulak and Boyer are the wideouts. 6:51 in the second quarter. Stacy Driver tries to come out of the pack. Almost got the football taken away and is stopped for a loss. Henry Harris, the initial hit.
Well, Henry Harris wasn't fooled at all on this play. We're going to see him penetrate into the Clemson backfield, and Driver has nowhere to go. Here comes the rest of the Georgia team.
Hatcher, with an average of 43.5 in this ball game, came into the contest ranked 9th nationally as a punter with great hang time. Is going to call back for some reserve strength right now. Harold coming under the football at midfield. Gets to the 45, and good pursuit that time by special teams for the Clemson Tigers. But the Bulldogs at midfield with good field position. With the score, Clemson 10, Georgia 3. We'll pause now for a word from your local station. This is the Raycom Sports Network. Bulldogs take over at the 45 with Tate at tailback. Smith is the fullback. It goes to Tate. Nice cutback. Jeff Wells got just enough of a hit to throw him off balance. Tate's a quick runner. He's a freshman. A high school All-American came into the ballgame. 11 carries, 31 yards, and one touchdown.
A nice cutback that time. Georgia running into the short side of the field. Tate cut it back up for good yardage.
Tate has a good combination of power and speed, 4-5 speed, but this time he's got caught around the ankles by Tyrone Davis. A loss on the play.
Tyrone Davis gets great penetration here to toss sweep, and look at Davis in the backfield. Nowhere for Tate to go that time.
4 carries, 22 yards for Tate. And it'll be second and 12 from the 36-yard line. Meadows flanks Curry to the right. Todd Williams taking it himself, and the Bandit turns back with the high tackle out of bounds.
And this is a broken play. Williams wanted to pitch this ball to his left. Someone's out of position, nowhere to go. He does the right thing, tucks it up, and gets what he can.
Three Clemson, 4:58, second quarter. Third down and 10 from the 34. Williams has Tate, and he gets it through to the 30 and can't hold on. A vicious hit by Keith Williams. 12 tackles this year, and that's got to be his best.
Well, Keith Williams really baited Lars Tate and Todd Williams. He was standing right in front of Tate, just waiting for him to throw the ball, let them open it up. So Williams might throw the ball to him, and here he comes. Puts the helmet right on the ball. That's the way it's supposed to be done.
So Kevin Butler as you see there, number five, getting set to try his third field goal of the ball game. He's 1 for 2 so far, the ball placement at the 41-yard line.
This is not a chip shot.
He's proven to have the leg before. Let's see if he can get the 51-yarder. It's up. If it's straight, it's good. It is good. Kevin Butler comes through. A 51-yard field goal. Well, earlier, Kim, we said the kicking game would play a big part. That's certainly been the case so far.
Well, 51 yards, and the ball still made it into the end zone stand, too.
What we expected, a great ball game here in Athens, Georgia. Clemson 10-6 over Georgia with 4:45 remaining before halftime. Butler's 50-yard field goal capped an 11-yard drive and 4 plays, 1:16 elapsed on the clock. The biggest yardage maker for the Bulldogs, penalties against the Tigers to put their backs to the wall and eventually punt. So Butler puts it out on the sideline. There's no way they can return that. If it bounced out the sideline, it would go to the 20. But it went out on the fly.
Right, they're bringing that out to the 30.
4:45 remaining second quarter. Clemson with the football at the 30-yard line. First and 10. Clemson leading at only 10-6. Epley hands to Flagler. Nice defensive adjustment that time. Close in yardage with Georgia 94 yards. Clemson 103. Clemson has a good 50% game really going for them and 49 passing yards. And 45 rushing, whereas Georgia picked up most of their yards on the ground. Second down and 8 from the 32. Epley hesitates, but it's back to Flagler. Flagler, beautiful move on Sanchez. Flagler down to the 30-yard line. Calvin Ruff finally making the stop, having to come all the way from the left end spot. What a great move by that young man.
And a great block by number 40, Henry Carter, the fullback. We'll see it right here. He kicks out the cornerback, and the great move there by Flagler. What a move.
Flagler's 52nd yard and 3 carries. You mentioned Henry Carter's block, Tim. He was the ACC Rookie of the Week against Virginia, mainly because of his blocking. 5 knockdown blocks. Up the middle this time on a 1st and 10 from the 30-yard line, and almost, well, make it the 24-yard line. A pickup of 4 yards on the play. Lovelace made the tackle.
Well, Carter that time put Tony Flack, the left cornerback, in the nickel seat. He came right back on this play with another fine block.
Second down and 6 now for the Tigers. Stacy Driver at tailback. Bill Carter at fullback. Huddley on the stunt was taken out, but someone was left free, and it was Hewitt. Carlisle Hewitt. Driver looked like he had an initial opening that time as Knox Culpepper, number 48, was picked up blitzing. But then somebody has to go free.
Well, Carter and Culpepper met in the background. Henry Carter 6'3", 215. Culpepper 6'1", 219. That time he got the best of it. They've got a 3rd and 7.
And that's from the 27-yard line. Epley going back, looks for the long throw. Gets it to number 33. That's Flagler. Terrence Flagler, touchdown. Epley's been able to do that all year long so far. Now in the 3rd game of the season, he's been able to unload long.
Well, this is a throwback. Epley's going to roll to his left. Now what they had been doing is have Flagler hooked up on this play, but this time he's got man-to-man coverage on John Little, and they sent Flagler down the sidelines, and he beat his man. Epley with a nice touch, good timing pattern.
Epley's hit Williams for a 46-yarder, Rulak for a 34-yarder, and connects this time with Flagler out of the backfield. Igwe-Wike now prepares for the extra point try. It's up, it's powerful enough, and it is good. So he remains perfect in extra point tries, puts it 17-6. Let's look at it again.
Well, this is interesting because Clemson took the whole first half setting this play up. Flagler's been going down about 10 yards hooking up. This time he just streaks down the sideline. And John Little couldn't cover him man-to-man. I don't think anybody can cover Flagler man-on-man. And a great call by Clemson and a great throw by Epley.
Super block by Henry Carter once again as he picked off the left end Andy Loy as he pursued the passer. 17-6 Clemson on top of Georgia. Igwe-Wike preparing to kick off now after a 70-yard drive and five plays. Capped by the 27-yard touchdown pass Epley to Flagler. Put a good bit into it. And they'll let it roll through. It'll come out to the 20. Andre Smith. Looks like he might have had a chance to run that back, but it was a good 5 yards deep in the end zone. So the Bulldogs will take over from their own 20-yard line. It's been an interesting first half with several momentum shifts. Started off like Clemson was going to tear away with this ball game. Then Georgia taking advantage of penalties and putting things together defensively, came back. Only have Clemson now to break out in front 17-6. Todd Williams looking for Archie, and he dumps it short, and it's almost intercepted. Let's see. Yes, it is intercepted. Tyrone Davis's second interception of the day.
Well,
the third of the season, Jim.
And the strange thing about this is Peter Anderson, the center for Georgia, really causes this interception. He's going to peel back and block for Williams. But watch him get in Williams' face. And that causes Williams to float the ball high. And here comes the interception. Tough break for Georgia.
So Williams is having a tough day. 3 out of 11, 4 interceptions for only 24 yards through the air. And Ty Davis gets his second interception. So with 2:16, the Tigers in great field position at the 31. Flagler. Directed Kenny Flowers, fumbles the ball, but he was already down. Maybe let's check it. I think the official said he already had the knee down, but the ball popped out. Max Culpepper, the tackler. Flowers gains a yard and a half on the play. Let's check the replay now. Stewart trailing from behind. Yes, he was down when the ball popped out. 1:45 before halftime. Epley not having his best percentage day, that's for sure. Coming into this game, number one pass efficiency-wise is 4 for 12 with one interception, but he does have 76 yards thanks to the long bomb. Now it's 3rd and 8, an important call for the Tigers. Ball resting at the 29-yard line. Epley back to Driver. Driver really is corralled, but somehow sneaks through for a yard gain. Bill Stacy Driver looks like a bowling ball. And he just kept those legs driving against Bill Mitchell and Max Culpepper, the two linebackers.
And kind of a surprising call, 3rd and 8. Down inside your opponent's 30-yard line, they choose to go off tackle out of the I formation. Now look, they've got Igwe-Wike in the game. They're going to be attempting the field goal.
There you see Peretti, number 17, the backup quarterback, the holder for Igwe-Wike. It's Scott Williams, the snapper from Hickson, Texas. Ball placement at the 33-yard line. It sails high. It is good. So what a kicking game we're seeing here today. Something we anticipated, but with 54 seconds left on the clock, the Tigers put 3 more on the board. Clemson 20, Georgia 6. And it's interesting, I think, to note, Jim, that the Tigers' next opponent, Georgia Tech, is currently leading 21-0 over the Citadel. So maybe they have shaken their second game jitters. I know they came off beating Alabama in the first game. They did that, in 1981 and then lost 10 games after that. But it looks like the Tech Yellow Jackets are here to stay for good in the ACC in a very competitive level.
Well, they had the big game against Alabama. You know, Tech, it'll be an interesting matchup, the Tech-Clemson game, because Georgia Tech has one of the largest offensive lines in football, and of course Clemson's got that very physical defensive line.
His longest, a 44-yarder, Igwe-Wike, is 2 for 2 in this ball game, and he's getting set to kick off. There's a single safety now as they're anticipating an onside kick after the 44-yard field goal and only 54 seconds on the clock. Jimmy Harrell is standing back on his 3-yard line, but look at him line up at the 47 and the 40 with some good hands people up there. Wojcicki puts it high, and Harrell goes back to catch it. And he won't run that out. So evidently, the Bulldogs were anticipating an onside kick. So the Bulldogs take over first and 10 from their 20-yard line, trailing at 20-6. With almost a minute remaining. Defensively for the Tigers now, it's Walls back in at linebacker. Brown, Danforth, Davis, and Pleasant, the secondary. Gary at tailback. Williams hands off up the middle and struggling to get to the 24-yard line, almost the 25. Is Andre Smith, the fullback. Henry Walls getting off the pile.
You're going to see Georgia just straight ahead right up the middle. They don't want to make the big mistake down here. There's 28 seconds left. They're letting the clock run.
Crawford's getting the initial hit there, as we saw in the replay, as it goes back to the tailback. A Bulldog loses his helmet up from the trenches as Steve Berlin makes the tackle for the Tigers. 13 seconds. So Coach Vince Dooley of the Georgia Bulldogs content now to run the clock off and start anew in the second half. The clock ticks down. And that's the end of the first half of Athens, Georgia, with the score. The Clemson Tigers 20, the Georgia Bulldogs 6. Kevin Butler will be kicking off to begin the second half. You know, Kim McCloughan, I think it's interesting that of four turnovers by the Georgia Bulldogs, they have not been able to capitalize on those turnovers. Only one has really led to the score for Clemson.
Well, one has led to a score, that's correct. But what it's done is really put the field position into Clemson's advantage. Even if you don't get a score out of a turnover, it may lead to a score on the next drive or the drive after that because you've been left in good field position.
Kevin Butler, whose two field goals account for the 6 Georgia Bulldog points. Rulak and Williams back on their goal line, anticipating Butler's kick. Butler comes forward and the second half is underway. A high booming kick into the end zone. Rulak fields it. He will not run it out. So the Tigers will begin their drive on the 20-yard line. Incidentally, the 70-yard touchdown drive by the Clemson Tigers in the first half was their longest of the year. Twice they have moved the ball 69 yards in the two previous games. Twice they moved it 68 yards. To have a 70-yard sustained drive against the Bulldogs is quite an accomplishment. Stacy Driver will start the second half at tailback, and Kenny Powers at fullback. Richard Butler at the split end. Ray Williams, your flanker back. And, of course, Epley at quarterback. J.D. Dunn shifts to the left side of the line. Stacy Driver gets the call. Beautiful hole. And it bottles up quickly, but he gets to the 25-yard line. Kenny Powers. It was Driver, who I was looking at, that made the block, and Bill Mitchell made the tackle.
And a nice block by the left guard, Steve Reese, that time. Considered the most consistent Clemson lineman.
So it'll make it a 2nd and 5 from the 25 for the Tigers. Epley making sure everyone hears the call. Stacy Driver, the tailback. Nice cutback as Georgia had a chance to load up on the outside. It took a little while for that play to develop. Close to the first down, though.
Well, here we see the toss sweep. Driver trying to get to the outside. Flowers out in front of him. Good block by Flowers, but the rest of the Georgia defense pursues well.
Inches short of the first down. 3rd and 1 at the 29. Epley, the quarterback, he gets the first down, moving over the 30-yard line. Carlisle Hewitt making the tackle. Hewitt with a good first half. He's from Snellville, Georgia, 6'2", 211-pound senior. Already a three-year letterman. Max Culpepper, number 48, looking to the bench for the defensive signals. Clemson with one more first down than Georgia. On Epley's move from the 20 and the 31-yard line now. Richard Butler and Ray Williams, the wide receiver. Epley taking a lot of time. Can't hold on the far side. Williams, I believe.
Well, Mike Epley had Williams open this time on a five-step look-in pattern. Really didn't get his feet set the way he'd like to, the way he generally does. Pulled the string a little bit, got an incompletion in the second and 10.
This has been a real test for Epley, the first defense that's actually challenged the Tigers. Sheldon Boyer to the far side, Williams to the near side, and Epley fairly got the ball away. The exchange is fumbled, and a big break for the Bulldogs at the 30-yard line. Carlisle Hewitt jumps on the football.
Well, we are not going to see a smooth exchange between Epley and Flowers. There you see Epley falling down. Looks like he didn't want to give the ball to Flowers, but he took it anyway. And Hewitt comes up with the ball for the Georgia Bulldogs.
Looks like a reenactment of the old belly series, where the quarterback actually rides with the fullback up to the line and then gives it to him or takes it back at the last second. Fullback on the carry, Smith. Bangs it down to the 26-yard line, almost to the 25.
Billy Georgia just came back with the same play that Clemson fumbled on. They ran it to perfection. Got five.
Almost even the turnovers now, Kim.
This is the kind of mistake Danny Ford wanted to avoid in his second half.
Two of those three fumbles go by the Tigers have been deep in their own territory. Second and five at the 25. Back to Tate. Tate short of the first down by a yard. The ball placement actually 2 yards short of the first down at the 22, where Eldridge Milton makes the tackle. Milton, an experienced linebacker. He had a great game against Georgia last year. 78 stops overall on the season for Milton. But he had 17 tackles against the Bulldogs last year.
Well, then Clemson would like to see him make one right here. This is a big third and two.
Number 22, Pace. Does not make the first down. Once again, they might call on Butler as Michael Perry and Eldridge Milton once again combined to clog up that middle.
Well, you're going to see a good job by William Perry and Steve Berlin. They double-team Steve Berlin. But there's a host of Clemson defenders penetrating into that Georgia backfield. They've got a fourth and one now, Art.
And Dooley's going to go for it. Fourth and one at the 21-yard line. Tate, he's got the first down inside the 20 to the 19. Steve Berlin at the bottom of the pack.
We're going to see a good surge here by Jimmy Holt, number 66, the right guard. Mike Weaver, the right tackle, number 63. Here it is. Holt comes down, double-teaming William Perry. Just enough room there for the first down.
Holton and Anderson on the double team there, and Weaver was able to get a nice block on the outside, as you mentioned. First and 10 now. The Bulldogs at the 19-yard line of Clemson. Tate. Oh, a nice adjustment on the far side by Dwayne Meadows, and then Eldridge Milton, the linebacker. Michael Perry, number 91, you'll see, also in on the play.
Well, Georgia tries a misdirection here. Faking right, coming back to their left. Michael Perry really stays at home, does not go with the flow, and makes a nice play. Jeff Wells also in there.
Second and 11 now from the 20-yard line. key series for the Bulldogs. Williams has his man in the open. Archie can't get it to him. He had a nice move on Ronald Watson. Watson was decent position, but Archie had the angle. Williams just couldn't get him the ball. Didn't drill it.
Herman Archie went down in the end zone, made a move to his outside. Williams on the run just couldn't put the ball on him.
3 for 12, only 24 yards through the air.
Here we see Todd Williams. He's got good protection. Floats the ball just a little bit. Herman Archie wide open, and I'm sure Todd Williams would like that ball back.
If Williams would have snapped that ball off when Archie made the cut, that could have been a touchdown for the Bulldogs. 3rd and 11. He's going to lob in the corner to Archie again. Touchdown! This one over Tyrone Davis.
Well, credit Todd Williams because he came right back and throws the touchdown pass. Tyrone Davis got himself out of position right at the line of scrimmage. Clemson came up in a bump and run. Here's Georgia throwing the fade. Herman Archie just takes one step and then goes back to the outside, and Tyrone never got himself adjusted. Couldn't see the football, and Archie came back to make the touchdown.
Looked like a good play call from the press box, the coaching box.
Well, that's exactly right, because Clemson came right up with everybody on the line of scrimmage.
Kevin Butler to the side for the extra point. It is up, and it is good. So the Bulldogs here in the second half make a move to get back into the ball game.
Williams just a three-step drop to his right and lets it go. There you see Davis is already beat. Archie's got to come back for the ball. Nice catch.
Herman Archie has 4 inches on Tyrone Davis anyway, plus the fine move he made. Archie is 6'5". So with 10:04 remaining third quarter, Clemson 20, Georgia 13. We'll pause now for a word from your local station. This is the Raycom Sports Network. Archie Williams, 20-yard reception, capped a time of possession drive of 3 minutes and 3 seconds. Moving the ball after the fumble, 30 yards in 7 plays. So the turnover proving costly to the Tigers as Kevin Butler prepares the kickoff. It'll be short. Rulak, number 15, fighting with Williams. It's Rulak from the 5. He only gets out to the 16-yard line. And so Clemson.
Momentum shifted back to the Georgia side of the field. You know, credit Vince Dooley. He had a 4th and 1, and it was a 4th and long 1. But he felt he had to do something to turn this game around, and he went for it. He felt he had the momentum to make the first down, and he was right and came out of the drive with a touchdown. This is a new ball game, Mark.
Sellout capacity crowd. Equaling the number here in Athens, Georgia, back in 81. Largest crowd ever to see a Clemson football game. From the 16, the Tigers with a 1st and 10. They try it with Flagler. Flagler with a gain of 3 after Knox Culpepper made the hit.
Well, you can really feel that home field advantage coming into play now as the crowd gets behind Georgia. Georgia sitting in their standard 4-man defensive front.
Flagler, who hasn't lost a yard so far this season, averaging 7.9, could get only 3 that time. Epley tucks it under. Not the first down. He'll be a few yards shy as he moves the ball to the 23-yard line. Donald Chumley comes to make the tackle.
Well, this is a good play by Epley. You're going to see him fake to his dive back. Not too much he could do with this ball. Georgia had it strung out. He just cuts it up and gets what he can. That's good positive yardage. He's at least got his team in position now for a 3rd and 2.
Key 3rd down play for the Tigers. From the 23. The pitch back. 1st down penalty though. Under the wide receiver cutting across. Might have been an illegal block. Let's check it. Epley waiting on the delay before flipping it to Flagler.
You may be right. Richard Butler was out there, number 19. He may have come back illegally. There's Epley again. He's looking at that defensive end. He's got to pitch it early. Flagler's in pretty good shape. We saw the block come in there. Couldn't really see the point of contact, but they're going to call clipping.
So the breaks are going the Bulldogs' way, and it's because they're making their own breaks.
There we go. Let's see if we can see Butler come into the lower left-hand corner of our screen here. Right there, there's the block. He hit him from behind, and they're going to bring it back.
Clemson has been penalized 77 yards with 8 penalties in this ball game. George has been able to hold their penalties at 50 yards assessed against them in the first half.
Danny Ford shaking his head.
8:37 in the third quarter now. This is third and 14 from the 12. Epley, the pass, gets it through the arms of Dunn. Dunn was tied up on the play if we see the replay.
Well, Dunn didn't like it, but Georgia did a good job at the line of scrimmage. They're going to come out and fake the option. They want to make this look like the option, and Epley's going to set up, look for the throwback to his tight end. But he was tied up at the line of scrimmage by number 39, Andy Lloyd.
Patrick, from his own end zone, gets a high hang time. Fair catch. Called for at the 46-yard line. Kevin Harris, a Florida boy, calls for the fair catch. 8 minutes, 24 seconds remaining, third quarter. The Bulldogs taking over as Clemson leads it 20-13. We'll pause now for a word from your local station. This is the Raycom Sports Network.
Yes, the doctor is expecting you. We'll take care of your ear, honey.
Now take care of your teeth, sweetheart.
Your 24-hour station in Columbia, Channel 19.
Tate, there's William Perry. A tackle for a loss. There was an interesting quote in the Atlanta Constitution the other day. In that it mentioned that number 66 in your program is William Perry for Clemson. The blip on your radar scope is just near Hartwell Lake. And that's William Perry.
320 pounds.
That's paraphrasing. Second and 12. Williams back. He's got his man Archie. Fumbles the ball, picks it up luckily, and makes it down to the 30-yard line. Incomplete pass, they're going to say. I thought he had it long enough. But of course, we weren't looking from the same direction that the official was. He was looking right in on it.
You're right, but this is a tough call. There you see Clemson jumping offside. Play action pass. Williams sets up nicely. He's got good time. Let's it go down the middle to Archie. Oh boy, looks like he took a step with that ball, but he's got his back to us, and it's hard to see if he was juggling or not. Tough break for Georgia.
3:23 in the third quarter. Lanes at the slot to the left of the line on a third and 12 from the 43. Williams has good protection. He's got his man Archie again. First down. One-on-one with the linebacker. And Reggie Pleasant had to finally come up to help out.
Well, I'll tell you, Todd Williams may have done some growing up on this play because he's on a roll to his left. He let this ball go way before Archie made his break. He showed the confidence in his receiver and the confidence in their timing to let it go before the man even made his break. And that's the reason for the completion in the first down. A big play by Todd Williams that time.
37 yards in receptions now for Herman Archie on a first and 10 from the 40. Tate back up at the 35 after a gain of 4. Greg Crawford, number 49, another tackle. Penalty flag down on the field. Let's check it. No, there is no penalty flag. So Georgia will have a second and 5 from the 35. Looking much sharper on offense.
The one thing that college and pro coaches look for is a quarterback that can throw that out ball, because it takes a lot of anticipation and a lot of confidence, and Williams did it extremely well in that last play.
Archie split to the far side on the second and 5. Tate, the ball carrier. Beautiful block. He's pushed down on 20-yard line. Tyrone Davis will tackle. They collapsed that side of the line.
Well, that's exactly right. Morris takes a big back. He's 6'2", 215, but look how quickly he gets into the secondary. No one touches him. Tyrone Davis finally making the stop.
Tate coming off the field after 13 carries, 50 yards. His final save tally. Only a freshman, 2 minutes now left in the third period. The Bulldogs on the drive at the 20-yard line. Fullback on the carry. He slips to McCluskey. David McCluskey from Rome, Georgia, only a sophomore, but he's 215 pounds of powerful driving legs. Finally, Steve Berlin makes the tackle.
A great job by Mac Burrows that time, the left guard. Just straight ahead, man-on-man blocking.
Second down and two at the 12. Bulldogs coming back here in a good third quarter. The tailback got the leverage. Out of bounds at the 1 yard line. Watson running out there. Along with Andy Johnson,
Sean Jackson on the toss. And look at the speed this junior has. Great job staying in bounds down the sideline. Great balance.
Ron Jackson, number 25. He was off the team for a spell. Decided he didn't want to play. Came back, worked his way up through the scout team. First down and goal. Bulldogs knocking on the door. Touchdown! Cleveland, Gary, number 36, scores for the Bulldogs. And now Kevin Butler will come in with a chance to tie here in the third quarter.
Going to see Cleveland Gary over right guard. He's a freshman, 6'2", 219, barreling his way into the end zone. And really, Georgia taking something out of the Clemson playbook, coming at you with a bevy of running backs on this drive. And it's paid off for them.
Anderson the snapper, Harrell will hold for Butler. 1:13 on the clock, third quarter. Butler puts it up, and it is good. We've got a tied great ball game at Athens, Georgia, with the scores, Clemson 20, Georgia 20. We'll be right back after these words. All knotted up. Gary capping a 65-yard drive after a fumble recovery. Two Clemson fumbles, two scores for the Bulldogs in the third quarter. Oklahoma State. They've always played a big part in this series, this great rivalry. Come back to hunt the Tigers in the third quarter. We'll see if they can regain what Tim thought was the key, regain the poise. Ray Williams. Williams gets out to the 20-yard line, just beyond. They'll play just beyond the 20. Randy Jackson, a freshman from Atlanta, Georgia, made the stop on the special teams. 1:08 remaining, third quarter of action.
Well, it's developing into one of those games that whoever has the ball last is going to win.
Stacy Driver, the tailback, and Henry Carter is the fullback, number 40. Stacy Driver, nowhere to go. Linebacker Steve Boswell from Warner Robins, Georgia, a sophomore, made the tackle. Boswell got a letter last year as a freshman on his football team. And it'll be second and eight after the gain of two. Boyer to the far side and Rulak is to the near side. Epley. Rulak was completely covered by Kevin Harris.
Well, you're right, Art. Epley tried to force it into the double coverage that time. on a roll to his left. They had Rolak well covered down the sideline, both short and deep. And Clemson's got a third and eight.
Ball resting at the 22. The Bulldogs defense has been just terrific here in the third quarter. Epley completes the pass for the first down at the 40-yard line to Richard Butler. Butler from Ware Shoals, South Carolina, senior.
Well, in almost every play, Georgia is double-teaming the wide receivers. They did again on this play, but Richard Butler found an opening.
Nice pass.
Epley really threading the needle that time.
If Epley would have put it to his right, it would have been intercepted, or very possibly.
Throwing them open.
20 to 20 on the first and 10. The quick out this time goes to Butler, I believe. Harris making the stop for the Bulldogs. But a nice play call for some good yardage. Second down and two from the 48-yard line. At least the Tigers now get the heat of the end zone off their back.
Well, you're right. I like the play call. The last several times on first down, Clemson's got very little running the ball. They come out with a quick out, and they've got a second and three, second and two.
Stacy Driver looked like he had the route to the outside as the linebacker, or I should say the left guard, Henry Harris, cut inside, and he trips him up. That's the end of the third quarter with the score, Georgia 20, Clemson 20. We'll pause now for a word from your local station. This is the Raycom Sports Network. Vince Dooley and his staff doing a tremendous job in that third quarter as Danny Ford tries to rally his forces. Tied 20 to 20. Clemson now with a third and one at midfield. Ball resting in the 50-yard line. Epley on the quarterback seat. And it's Bill Mitchell to make the tackle. Mitchell with a great first game, 14 tackles against Southern Mississippi. Kenny Sims also helping out on the play. First down for the Clemson Tigers now as they move into Bulldog territory.
Yeah, well, they went to the power back that time, Art. When in doubt, go with the beef.
Those high-paid guys, right?
Be careful what you say about these college players now.
Well, I was talking about you. You're mostly known not from Lehigh, but from the Redskins and Falcons. KD Dunn, first down yardage, and more as he goes out of bounds at the 30. Andy Loy finally got a hand and pushed him out, along with John Little.
Oh, a well-designed play. I like the imagination on this. We're going to fake the quick pitch to Epley's right. He's going to bootleg out here all by himself. Dunn's open, and a good individual effort by Dunn after he catches the ball.
Little the miss, and Loy the hit. Look at the linebackers here, Kim.
Look at the linebackers go with the flow. They're still out of the play. That's great play making.
First and 10 from the 30. Flowers. Gain of a yard on the play. Kirby Stewart, a freshman defensive guard from Moultrie, Georgia, for the tackle.
That last pass play to Dunn was so effective because Clemson pulled both guards and sent them in the opposite direction. Epley out there all by himself on the bootleg. The linebackers read the guards for their key. That time it took them out of the play.
Rulak and Boyer, the wide receivers, on a second and eight from the 28. Out of the straight drop, we go to Rulak. It's intercepted by Flack. Tony Flack at the 20-yard line, and a penalty flag is down. KD Dunn made the tackle on Flack. Looked like Epley just didn't see Flack. He threw it right to him.
Well, stating the obvious, I know Mike Epley would like to have this ball back. It's a straight drop back pass. He's got plenty of time in the pocket. Good job by the offensive line. Wants to throw the in ball, but just doesn't see the defender. And Tony Flack comes up with the ball.
And a clipping penalty on the run back.
Right.
We'll put the ball back to the 3-yard line. .13-44 to go in this ball game, where one break could win it. It's all tied at 20-20. Williams comes into a huddle that has Gary at the tailback. McCluskey at fullback. Todd Williams, good quick pursuit that time. Terrence Mack. Correction, Kenny Danforth. Looked like it was going to be a big gainer when it formed up, Jim.
Well, this is very similar to the play Epley ran on the bootleg. Williams out here all by himself, but this was run all the way. No pass option. Kenny Danforth stayed at home. He wasn't fooled. Came up with a big tackle.
Keith Johnson, 6'5", 305 pounds in his center now. A junior who has not played since the Cotton Bowl. His first practice, in fact, in pads was Wednesday. Gary on the carry. And give it to the 7-yard line. Eldridge Milton holding him down.
And Reggie Pleasant that time made a nice play, forcing the ball carrier inside. He's only 5'10", 175, but he took on one of the big offensive linemen of Georgia that time.
Osborne comes into the game as a wide receiver, and he's the lone wide receiver to the right. Third and 7. Todd Williams has his man. Can he get him the ball? No. Osborne was wide open, and Williams overshot him.
Well, what a shame. They had a great opportunity here to get it all. Williams on the rollout. He pump faked. They were running it down and out and up.
Osborne just couldn't get there. He's got great speed.
He made a great move at about 15 yards. He faked the out move and then cut it up.
Osborne, the quickest freshman on this team, at a 4-4 40. Andrews punted twice, average of 45 yards. Reggie Pleasant has to do some backpedaling. Beautiful hang time back to 34. And he goes nowhere. Does the wise thing, actually. With the score, Clemson 20, Georgia 20. We'll pause now for a word from your local station. This is the Raycom Sports Network. Flagler then, Igwe-Buike. Here's the 2nd and 4. Intercepted at the 46-yard line. Tony Flack, second straight interception. Intended for Richard Butler, and Flack brings him through again.
Well, this is the throwback again. Epley rolling left, looks back to his right. Butler was coming underneath the coverage. Epley a little too high with the ball, deflected, and Georgia comes up with another turnover.
So now Clemson has 6 turnovers to Georgia's 5. And a great break again for the Bulldogs. They're making their breaks in this ball game. 1st and 10 at the 47-yard line. Tron Jackson, the tailback, and he'll get the call. Good speed, uprooted by number 32. That's Kenny Danforth.
Well, this is a quick screen or a split screen to George's right side. They had Jimmy Holton, the offensive right guard, out there in front of the ball carrier. Kenny Danforth did a great job of eluding the block and making the tackle. They still came up with 6, though.
From the 47, 2nd down and 4 yards to go for the 1st down. Clemson defense. A great challenge here. The pitch man. 1st down, Tron Jackson. Keith Williams was the first to get a hand on him.
We're going to see the option into the short side of the field. Here's the fake to the dive back. Williams lets it go quickly. And they get it up for the 1st down.
Just shy of the 42-yard line. 11-18 remaining. The Clemson offense has been stymied by the Bulldogs. Two fumbles leading to touchdowns in the third quarter. Now two interceptions. Unable to make the play was Danforth, and Tron Jackson is finally forced out of bounds by Reggie Pleasant. Danforth was on the chase.
Looked to toss sweep. And Danforth does a nice job of disrupting the play, stringing it out.
Danforth gave Pleasant plenty of time to come up for a one-yard loss, second and 11 at the 43. Tailback makes it to the 40-yard line. A gain of three on the play. Tate is brought down by Michael Perry. So it'll be third. And make it a seven-yard situation for the Bulldogs.
I was about to say, we have another key third down situation. They seem to be endless in this game, 20-20.
Weaver and Holton are blocking up front on the right side of the line as Williams calls signal, third and nine at the 40. Osborne on the roll. Williams tries to get it to him, a little bit too low. He was in the open, though. Williams just couldn't get it to him. You know, Osborne is really interesting in that he's a freshman coming onto this team, and he came very close to retiring a Herschel Walker first-day freshman test record. It's called the broad jump.
The what?
Broad jump. You get three consecutive standing broad jumps. And he came in within the record, which is held by Herschel Walker, only one-tenth of an inch shy of the mark. Herschel just broke all freshman records on that particular test.
Including the frog.
You had some frog leaps when you're playing pro ball, I saw you. Andrews, three punts for 49 yards, hangs this one high. Will it go into the end zone? Yes. The wind is behind him, and it fails. So the Tigers get the football back. The defense doing a great job. Clemson 20, Georgia 20, with 10:20 remaining in the ballgame. We'll be back after these words. Ball placement on the 24. It'll be second and six. Weigler and Flowers, the running back. The Sun shifts to the near side. Epley on the option. Tucks it under. He won't pitch it back this time. He learned the first time, but he fumbles. Loose football. And Georgia again recovers.
Well, you just don't figure a Mike Epley to come in here and commit the kind of turnovers he's made today. He makes a great move here on the option to his left. He's going to turn it up. He sees the Georgia defense strung out. He makes the cutback here, and there it is. Number 31 for Georgia. Jeff Sanchez gets his hand in there on the ball and knocks it free. Georgia comes
Tully,
up.
I believe, picked up the loose football for Calvin Ruff. It's first and 10 Bulldogs at the 45. A great break. We'll see if they can convert. They've been able to so far the second half, breaking into the open. The fullback, Andre Smith. Good yardage over the 45, approaching the 40. Tyrone Davis finally called upon to make the stop. 9:21 remaining in this ball game, and the Bulldogs have dominated the second half.
Well, here you're going to see Andre Smith right up the middle. That's a big gainer on first down.
Gary, the tailback now from the 43. Henry Walls made the stop on him. Gary really couldn't get going, but he did get good yardage up to the 40-yard line. So Clemson now turned the ball over seven times, but it's really beginning to hurt. Georgia turned it over four times out of the five turnovers they have in the first half. But only one time did it result in any points. But Georgia has been able to take their turnovers from Clemson and score. Second and seven from the 40. Gary. He makes it to the 35, close to the first down. They'll probably pop the ball back a bit. Eldridge Milton the tackle.
Well, you really get the feeling that the Georgia offense has the Clemson defense off balance right now. There's the handoff. Doesn't look like much, but when you're getting 3, 4, 5 yards a pop, and you're looking at third and twos, those are a lot easier to convert than third and eight.
Two tight ends in the ball game. O'Leary to the far side. Gary the pitch. He's got the first down. Eldridge Milton the tackle. So the Georgia Bulldogs on the move once again.
It's a toss sweep to Georgia's left. Cleveland Gary, just enough for the first down. Georgia's got the most.
Perry that time went one-on-one with Anderson the center. First and 10 from the 31-yard line. Freddie Lane in motion. Hand off to Gary, and there was a mix-up back there as the blocking came right back into the ball. Michael Perry forcing the action. That time, Peter Anderson ended up near the handoff from his center spot.
Well, and the mix-up was William Perry knocking everybody back 2 or 3 steps, allowing his brother Michael to come in and make the play.
Takes the tailback. He gets the pitch and fumbles it, has to fall on it at the 35-yard line, so it's right at the line of scrimmage. Toss was a little bit behind him, I think, Jim.
Well, it's too bad because they had a big hole on the left side. They had the corner, just couldn't hang on to it.
Michael Perry going for the quarterback off that end and relying on Kenny Danforth to come up and secure the tackle. Third and 14 from the 35. The pitch back to Tron Jackson. Rolled out of bounds. Ronald Watson at the 28-yard line making the tackle. Let's take a look at the yardage in this ball game. Georgia now 303 yards. Clemson 240 yards.
And obviously what Vince Dooley was doing on that last play, third and 14, normally a toss sweep would be kind of a conservative, perhaps an unusual call, but when you've got a kicker like Kevin Butler and you've got the score tied 20-20 with 6:09 remaining, he's thinking field goal.
Well, as he proved in a 51-yarder earlier in the ball game, he's got the leg for it. It's a howitzer. It is good. Kevin Butler breaks the tie. Just embraced by Mike Cavan, their assistant coach. ...40 yards.
And obviously what Vince Dooley was doing on that last play, third and 14, normally a toss sweep would be kind of a conservative, perhaps an unusual call, but when you've got a kicker like Kevin Butler and you've got the score tied 20-20 with 6:09 remaining, he's thinking field goal.
Well, as he proved in a 51-yarder earlier in the ball game, he's got the leg for it. It's a howitzer. It is good. Kevin Butler breaks the tie. Gets embraced by Mike Cavan, their assistant coach, as he comes off the field and gets set for the kickoff. Kevin Butler puts Georgia ahead for the first time in this ball game. With 6:03 remaining, Georgia 23, Clemson 20. We'll pause now for words from your local station. This is the Raycon Sports Network. They only had the ball 3 minutes, 26 seconds, went 29 yards with it. Kevin Butler. Williams in the end zone will not run it out, so Clemson takes over from their 20. What a turnaround here in the second half.
Well, it really has been. It's been all Georgia, and really they've done it on the ground. Vince Dooley's concern at the beginning of the season was his inexperienced offensive line, but in the second half here, they've done a great job against a very tough Clemson defensive line.
Well, they were more than satisfied with the performance in their first game of the season, Southern Mississippi. Then they had a week off, as Clemson did, to prepare for this game. Epley out of the backfield. That's Flowers. And he's met hard there, close to a first down at the 30. Good play call for the Clemson Tigers as they had a big rush on.
Well, I like this play call by Clemson on first down. Straight drop back pass. It's a possession type pass. Swinging the back out of the backfield. Epley gets a chance to put the ball right on the numbers. They move the chains. A good first down call.
Greg Waters, the hit for Georgia. And from the 30 now with a first down. Flowers. Gets around the linebacker. Can't get any good yardage, though. Penalty flag is down. It might be a holding call.
Well, here you see the Georgia linebackers. Culpepper and Mitchell. Mitchell's going to come up. He's going to get a part of the ball carrier. Good play. They weren't fooled. That was a draw play. Georgia didn't bite on it.
I couldn't see on that replay or not, but there was a hold at the line. One of the Bulldogs crediting Engel with the hold. But it sets the ball back to the 20-yard line. Clemson down by three with 5:26 remaining in this contest. Oh, is it hard to win between these hedges? Danny Ford knows better than anyone. He has not won here yet. 87 yards in penalties for Clemson.
Well, it's extremely hard to win anywhere when you commit seven turnovers.
That's true. Clemson has only won one game and 16 tries before this game. Dumps it off to Stacy Driver. Driver, a nice sidestep at the 25. So that'll get some of the yardage back.
Well, the most impressive part of the Georgia defense today has been its secondary. They've done a great job of covering the receivers downfield. Epley wants to go downfield on this play, but instead he has to go to his safety valve. Stacy Driver is one of those few backs that can turn a safety valve play into a 15-yard gain.
So it'll be second, almost back to the original line of scrimmage. They're calling it second and 10 from the 30. Epley. And he goes to a K.D. Dunn. Here we got a situation, Kim, where the linebackers are so far back, they're daring the Tigers to throw underneath them.
Well, that's exactly right. Georgia was back in almost a prevent-type defense that time, playing a zone. K.D. Dunn just went down a few yards, hooked up. They would have liked to see K.D. keep his feet, maybe get a few extra yards out of that, but he had to come back to catch the ball.
A big three. And about 3.5 yards to go for a first down. It's a long three. Let's see if they can convert it. You see the scoring there by Quarters, but we've got a more important situation right here. At the 37-yard line, Epley. Can he get it around? He pitches back. Driver's got the first down. Nicely executed that time by Epley.
Well, a great play by Epley this time. They go to the short side of the field. They run the option. As soon as he gets away from the center, he's eyeballing that defensive end. Here he comes down the line, fakes the pitch once, turns it inside, keeps his poise, gets a good pitch off the Driver. And Tony Flack's got to make the play after Driver picked up the first down.
Flack riding a block by Cheatham very, very well to make the play. And coming off the field is Loy, the left end, Andy Loy from Knoxville, Tennessee. So Calvin Rupp comes in his job. Hewitt and Chumley defensively now at the end spot for Georgia. Epley throws behind his intended receiver, and that was Terrence Flegler.
Well, Georgia was in a two-deep zone in this play. There you see the two safeties in the middle of the football field. They're going to double-team on the outside, both wide receivers. Flagler's going to come down the middle, which is where you want to attack that two-deep zone. But Epley's a little late with the ball, and behind him, they've got a second and 10.
Everybody floating back defensively. Good defensive call that time by the Bulldogs. Second and 10 from the 45-yard line, the deep drop. He's got his man, Williams, I believe. Let's check it when he comes out of that pile. Ray Williams completes the pass.
Well, this is
at
a
the
good,
46, a first down.
Excuse me, Art. This is a good throw and a good catch. Epley straight back in the pocket. He's going to have the time he needs to throw the ball. The real test of a wide receiver is how do you catch the ball coming across the middle? Ray Williams answers that question right here as he catches the ball in traffic and up for the first down.
And the clock continues to tick. 3:18 remaining in this ball game. 23-20, Georgia by three. First and 10 from the 43. Epley looking long, throws it up dangerously. Can't get to the ball. Butler, Richard Butler. Penalty flag at the line of scrimmage. This against Georgia this time. Baseman. Right up near the line of scrimmage, it looked like maybe one of the defenders trying to use the face mask to get in on Epley.
Well, Clemson gambled that time. They took a shot, went for the bomb. Not a bad decision with 3:05 left in the game. They've got to think in terms of a touchdown to win this game.
Epley.
Look at the time Epley's got. His offensive line doing a good job for him.
So it'll be first and six after the face mask. Urlach is the lone wide receiver. Stacy Driver to the wing on the near side. Freshman got Boyer on this side, too. Straight up the middle. Nice hole as he steps over one tackler, Kenny Flowers. Calvin Roof made the tackle. Flowers adjusting nicely on this run.
Well, this play develops just like the option play. Notice that time Flowers bumping into Epley. Their timing has not been good all afternoon. Earlier, they fumbled on that same play.
Engel with the block. First and 10 now from the 32-yard line. The Tigers moving on a very difficult Bulldog defense. Bulldogs have shut that out in the latter moments of this ball game. Epley lobbing one for Ray Williams. He impossible to get to. Epley ends up on his backside. Great rush by Donald Chumley.
Oh, and you wondered what Epley was signaling to his back behind him right before the snap. He pulled his hand away and gave him a sign. Perhaps one of the backs forgot to count and asked him what it was. He might have flashed two fingers back there for him, but they went for the bomb again. And good coverage by the Georgia defense.
Epley's been able to break games open with that bomb in the past, the first two games of the season. Threw a nice long one in this one. But right now, his club is trailing by three with 2:30 on the clock. Epley steps up. Almost intercepted. If it hadn't been for KD down, it would have been. Calvin Roof from his left end spot rode with KD Dunn.
Well, Georgia's back in their two-deep zone again, doubling the wide receivers. The place to go is go for the tight end down the middle. That's what Epley does, but Calvin Roof is all over him. And KD makes a good defensive play to break up the interception. Third and 10, Art.
Big one now for Clemson. You go for field goal positioning, 2:23 remaining. You've got 10 yards to go for a first down, third and 10. For the first down now. Defense flashed back. Epley out of the pocket. Nice receiver coming back, but he drops the ball. KD Dunn with a sure first down. Did everything right, but didn't catch the ball. When he saw Epley in trouble, he started coming back.
Well, that's exactly right. At the snap of the ball, Epley reads the coverage, and he wanted to go to his tight end in the middle of the field. But the coverage was on him, so after he moves, Dunn makes a move to the outside, gets himself open, and comes up with everything but the ball.
Donald Igwebuike now. Last year at Clemson, it was Butler that came in with seconds remaining to tie the game at 16. Now Igwebuike trying to tie it at 23. Kick is up. It's long enough. It is good. Donald Igwebuike ties this ball game with 2 minutes and 10 seconds remaining.
Well, just an incredible finish to this game, and we still got 2 minutes and 10 seconds left. But what a great clutch kick by Igwebuike.
There you see the score, Georgia 23, Clemson 23. We'll pause now for a word from your local station. This is the Raycon Sports Network. Igwebuike's 48-yard field goal, capping 12 plays, moving the ball 48 yards to tie the game at 23. Boy, it's difficult in this one, isn't it?
Trying to pick a player of the game.
If you had to pick a player of the game with such a close performance, I might go with Tony Flack out of the defensive secondary.
He's had a great game. That whole Georgia secondary has been tough.
Igwe Buike. It bounces in the end zone, and so they'll put it out at the 20. What a great dead hop it took in the end zone. And then you've got to think about Igwe Buike being the most valuable player as well.
Yes, absolutely. We might have to give it to Butler and Iggy.
The Bulldogs still with 2 minutes 10 seconds on the clock. They've got 80 yards to try to break the tie. Tron Jackson, the tailback, he's got lots of speed. Williams quickly over to Lane. Fred Lane makes it to the 24 yard line before Jimmy Danforth puts a helmet to it. Milton also in on the stop. Let's take a look, Jim.
Well, Williams on the roll to his right. Nice catch over the head. He gets the ball in the hands. That's the important thing. And they've got some yardage, but they need bigger chunks than that.
On the second and six from the 24, releases it to his back. Tron Jackson. First down, Yachty. Jeff Wells, number 88, to make the stop.
Well, this is a slip screen. To Georgia's left side, Tron Jackson's going to get the ball in the backfield. He's got Mac Burrows out in front of him. Peter Anderson out there as well. Good yardage.
Archie to the near side, Lane to the far side. First down at the 31-yard line. Williams gets the big rush. Incompleted pass to the near side. Intended for Archie, with Terrence Mack covering on Archie.
And Michael Perry
really came hard on Williams.
Really disrupts the timing of this play. Michael Perry does. We'll see the play action pass. I don't think anybody's going for that fake at this point in the ball game. Look at Williams just letting it go as Perry hits him.
All week long, Vince Dooley saying how his inexperienced club doesn't match up well, but you never know in this series. Danny Ford not buying any of that, of course. And they've just shown a fly. Oh, what an up. Let's every look out. What a game-saving tackle by Tyrone Davis. Tron Jackson.
Well, I mentioned on the last play that nobody was going for the play fake. This time, no one was playing the run. All the Clemson linemen upfield on the pass rush. Tron Jackson all by himself. And what a great game-saving tackle. Tyrone Davis.
Well, there's still a minute left, actually 59 seconds. Williams out to Fred Lane. Blue Fingers is horse counted by Eldridge Milton, number 87. 46, the clock is continuing to move. Georgia has one more timeout. Second and nine at the 44. Lane to the far side, and it's Archie to the near side.
Georgia needs at least one more substantial gain. They're going for it all.
Going for Freddie Lane. He can't get to the football. What a great try, though. Tyrone Davis on him.
Well, Todd Williams makes a great throw here.
Gets a lot of power into it, Jim.
A straight drop back pass. Little play fake there. He's got good time. Now, look at the time he's got. Let's it go. You want to put this ball on the receiver's outside shoulder. That's where it's coming down. Fred Lane had a shot at it. Would have been a great catch, but a nice throw by Todd Williams.
You know, I'm not sure that he might not have been looking up into a sunshine effect there.
You're right.
When trying to search for the football.
Well,
23 seconds on the clock. Osborne to the far side.
Kevin Butler's longest field goal is 59 yards.
Timeout is called by Williams. Oh, that's a tough one.
A kick from this spot on the field would be a 61-yarder. I'm sure he's made those kind in practice. But you know, Georgia would like to get at least 10 more yards to give him a shot at the winning field goal.
as long as the 59-yarder in 1982. He had a 52-yarder in 81, 59-yarder in 82, and a 53-yarder in 83.
I'll tell you, that's some kicking. You know, there you see the graphic. 17 points for Georgia. They've outscored Clemson 17-3 in the second half.
He has missed one at 51 yards today. 23-23 with 23 seconds remaining on the clock in this ball game. What a magnificent series this has been, Kemp. With Georgia in the last 10 years winning only one more game than Clemson and one game a tie. And that was last year. Will this one become a tie? Well, the Dogs are going to try to prove that they can do it on a 3rd and 9 from the 44. Williams looking for Osborne. Catches it, but it was out of bounds.
Well, it's 4th down. They're going to have to try and kick it. This is going to be a 61-yard attempt, Art. There are very few kickers in the country who would have a shot at this, but Kevin Butler happens to be one of them.
Kevin Butler. Ball placement at the 51. Harold the holder. Anderson the snapper. Looks like it might be far enough. It's good.
Unbelievable. Still 11 seconds on the clock. Unbelievable. Not only was it was good by at least 5 yards.
He had the wind going with him, and he got it up a strong leg, and he fired it over the crossbar.
Well, Kevin Butler kicked a field goal last year to tie this game with 38 seconds left. Comes back and kicks a 61-yard field goal to put the Bulldogs ahead 26-23.
Now, Igwe Buike's got the wind going in front of him. He's got a headwind, but he still's got 11 seconds. If Clemson could get a run back,
well,
or a good first play.
I'm afraid their only hope is to get the run back. You know that Butler's going to nail this kickoff back into the end zone, so there probably won't be a great chance for a return.
They're officially marking it as a 60-yard field goal for that young man, Kevin Butler, who already holds the record in the ACC for the most field goals.
Well, there
is the replay.
There we see the ball is well beyond the 50-yard line, so it's over 60 yards. Butler really gets into it. He kept his head down. That's the key to those long ones, and look at this. He knows he's got it. Got to be the biggest field goal of that man's career.
Yeah, Danny Ford warned everyone not to take Vince Dooley's comments too seriously about the inexperience. He says that's probably the same kind of information General Custer got before he went down to Little Bighorn. And the fans here, 82,000 strong, are going crazy. 26-23. Georgia and Clemson. We haven't seen this many points in a game between these two in some time.
Butler may kick this kickoff out of Athens.
Swift kick. Williams bobbling it. Has good blocking in front of him. Now he passes across the field. It's fumbled, picked up by Rulak. Rulak with good running room. He's to the 45, 40, and out of bounds. Time runs out.
Well, this is a great effort by Clemson. I'll tell you, I think there's some question as to the... Clemson's arguing there was 1 second left when he ran out of bounds. The officials are getting together on it. I looked at the clock, and it looked to me like there was time left on the clock as he got out of bounds.
It looked like there was time to me, but it's pretty hard to tell when he stepped out from across the field. Danny Ford interested in the decision, of course, because Igwe Buike would have a chance.
Clemson tried the lateral. Throwing a backward pass is legal on the kickoff.
Danny Ford stating his case. Evidently, the decision has been made. At least the crowd thinks so. There's Vince Dooley and Danny Ford. Well, Danny Ford's going to say home field advantage.
Well, he sure is. Rulak was out of bounds down around the 35-yard line.
And Georgia has upset the University of Clemson 26-23 on a 60-yard field goal by Kevin Butler. We'll pause now for words from your local station. This is the Raycon Sports Network. We thought you might be interested in seeing the reception, and we put a couple of stopwatches on this. Now, you've got Williams on the left and Rulak on the right. The swift kick goes to Williams. Bobbles it, picks it up, throws it over to Rulak, who saves the ball, actually, and runs out of bounds. And our timing on this, and two stopwatches came out 10 seconds with 11 seconds remaining before the kick. But it's so close, it's pretty hard to tell, and it's a very difficult decision, I know, for the officials down below. Today's brute player of the game is Kevin Butler for his game-winning 60-yard field goal, as well as terrific performance throughout the game. Great days seem to happen more often when you're wearing Brute by Fabergé. After shave, after shower, anytime, Brute by Fabergé. Art Ekman and Kim McWilkin. And Kim, it's about what we said. That kicking game is so vital, but it was the Bulldogs' defense and putting it together on offense on the running game in the second half that just turned the ball game around from a halftime advantage of Clemson.
Well, it was a hard-fought game on both sides of the field. The difference is that Clemson, the favorite, came in here, committed seven turnovers, and it's tough to go into Georgia, go into Sanford Stadium, commit seven turnovers, and win the ball game, and I think that was the difference.
We'd like to thank the Sports Information Director Claude Felton from the University of Georgia and from Clemson University Sports Information Bob Bradley. We'd also like to thank our assistant directors Tom Howard and Al Littlejohn. Today's game was directed by Toby Jenkins, produced by Tom Courtney. This is Art Ekman along with Kim McQuilkin saying thank you for being with us. The final score from Sanford Stadium, Clemson 23, the University of Georgia winning by 3, scoring 26 points.